Introduction to Centimeter, Part 1. Today we will learn how to measure length and how to find if an object is shorter, longer, or of equal length compared to any other object. Neha and Vandana are playing with sand today and building a fort for their dolls.
Look, Vandana, I have made a fort for our dolls.
Oh, wow. This looks very beautiful. Come, let's make our dolls sit in this fort.
Hey, this fort is small for your doll. Your doll can be seen above the fort.
Yes, you should have checked the height of my doll before building the fort.
Yes, you are right. Let's make another fort in which even your doll can easily fit in. Tell me, what is the height of your doll, Vandana?
I don't know. Let's measure it now. Look, the height of my doll is 15 centimeters.
Let us find the height of my doll too.
The height of your doll is 10 centimeters.
What is the height of the fort?
The height of the fort is 12 centimeters.
That's why your doll was not fitting in the fort. We will have to build a 15 centimeter tall fort for your doll. Let's build it.
Now the fort is ready. Let's measure it.
The height of the fort is 15 centimeters now.
That means both our dolls will completely fit in this fort now, right?
Now our dolls will fit in this fort easily.
Did you notice one thing?
What?
That my doll is taller than your doll.
Yes, but how much taller is your doll than my doll?
That's easy to find. Your doll is 10 centimeter tall. And my doll is 15 centimeter tall. If we subtract the height of your doll, which is 10 centimeters, from the height of my doll, which is 15 centimeters, we will come to know how much shorter is your doll from my doll.
If we subtract 10 from 15, we will get 5. That means your doll is 5 centimeters taller than my doll.
Yes, and we can also say that your doll is 5 centimeters shorter than my doll.
Yes, now if I want to get a doll which is the same size as that of your doll, then I have to buy a doll of 15 centimeters.
Yes, and if you want to buy a doll taller than my doll, then you have to buy a doll taller than 15 centimeters.
It means that if I want to buy a doll which is of the same size as that of your doll, then I need not carry your doll. I just have to carry the scale, right?
No, there is no need to carry the scale too. You can easily ask for a doll of 15 centimeters.
That's right. Does this mean that the measurement of centimeters is same in every scale?
Yes, but with such a small scale, we can only measure objects that are up to 15 centimeters in length. If we want to measure objects longer than 15 centimeters, then how do we do it?
I believe there are longer scales available.
Yes, but where will we get longer scales from?
Why don't we ask Papa tomorrow? Maybe he knows.
Yes, let us do that.
Today we learned that centimeters are used to measure height. By measuring objects, we can find whether an object is shorter, longer, or of equal height compared to other objects. Introduction to Centimeter, Part 2. Today we will learn that there are different types of scales and different scales are used to measure objects of different lengths.
Hello, Uncle.
Hello, Vandana.
Papa, we want to ask you something.
Tell me, what do you want to know?
Yesterday we were measuring the height of our doll. We use centimeters to measure the height.
But the scale we had was only 15 centimeters long.
We want to know how to measure some object if it is more than 15 centimeters long. Is there a scale that is longer than 15 centimeters?
Yes, and I have it. You can go to your room and I'll bring it there. Your toys can also be measured with this scale. Look, I have these three scales.
Even we have this scale, Papa.
Yes, and this is the scale we used yesterday to measure our dolls.
This scale can only measure objects which are up to 15 centimeters in length. Now look at this scale and tell objects of what length can be measured using this scale.
Papa, it has a mark up to 30 centimeters on it.
That means it can measure objects up to 30 centimeters length, right?
Absolutely right.
Come, let us measure our toys, Vandana.
I will measure the length of my toy giraffe.
Now let us see what is its length. Your giraffe is 25 centimeters tall. Now I will measure the height of my bear.
Now let's see what is its height. Your bear is 20 centimeters tall.
Can you both tell how short is the bear than the giraffe?
Yes, Uncle. We will subtract the height of the bear from the height of the giraffe.
The height of the giraffe is 25 centimeters and the height of the bear is 20 centimeters.
Subtracting 20 centimeters from 25 centimeters will leave us with 5 centimeters.
This means that the giraffe is 5 centimeters taller than the bear.
You both answered it correctly.
But Papa, if we want to measure something longer than 30 centimeters, how will we measure it?
For that, we will use this scale.
But Uncle, this scale is very small.
No, this scale is very long. So long that it can measure your height.
Our height? With this scale? How?
To use this scale, the handle outside it has to be held and pulled. Pulling this handle brings the scale out. And with this scale, we can measure the height.
Uncle, can you measure our height?
Sure. You both stand against the wall. Neha, your height is 138 centimeters. And Vandana, your height is 140 centimeters.
This scale is very good. With this, we can measure long objects. Can we take this scale? We will measure the length of more objects, Papa.
Why not? You can keep this scale with you. Today we have seen three types of scales which are used to measure length. And different scales are used to measure various objects according to their length. Introduction to Centimeter, Part 3. Today we will learn how to use a scale correctly to measure objects and how to measure objects correctly using a broken scale.
I think your pencil is shorter than my pencil. It looks equal to me. Let us measure and see. I will measure my pencil and you measure yours.
My pencil is 10 centimeters long. Now you measure your pencil.
My pencil is 12 centimeters long. I told you, my pencil is longer than your pencil.
It should not be because both our pencils are new. Show me.
See.
Now I know why this is happening.
What did you understand?
Look, you have placed the bottom end of your pencil at 2 centimeters, while I have placed the bottom end of my pencil at 0 centimeters.
What difference does that make?
It leads to incorrect measurements. To measure the correct length of objects using a scale, we should place their lower end at 0, like I have done.
Oh, I understand now. The problem with keeping the pencil at 2 cm is that there is no pencil from 0 cm to 2 cm. And I included that length as well in the measurement. Now I'll correct it. I'll keep the pencil at 0 cm.
Yes, it's correct. Now you will be able to tell the exact length of the pencil.
My pencil is also 10 cm. Let's measure some more objects.
Oh, your scale is broken.
How will I measure the length of objects now?
I think we can measure the length of objects with this broken scale too.
How?
Let us try and measure the pencil with this broken scale. We start counting from the least centimeter mark.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11.
Why is the pencil measuring 11 centimeters? We just measured it. It was 10 centimeters then.
It means we have made some mistake.
Let's do one thing. Let's try to measure this pencil with the correct scale. Then we might come to know our mistake.
I will start counting again. One. Wait.
What happened? Look. The correct scale has a zero written at the starting point. While measuring with the broken scale, we are starting from one.
This means whenever we measure using a broken scale, we will still start from zero.
Yes. Let's measure now.
Zero. One. Two. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10.
10 centimeters. Now the measurement is correct.
We need to remember these two rules while measuring any object. The 0 centimeter point of the scale will be placed at the beginning of the object. And to measure an object, we will start from 0 marking on the scale.
Related word problems. Today we will learn how to use measurement for everyday task.
Oh wow, mango! Grandpa, can I eat one?
Yes, you can eat it, but will you help me first?
Yes, Grandpa.
We have to send all these mangoes to our friends and relatives. So first, put the mangoes in these boxes.
How many boxes do we need, Grandpa?
Try to add and find out the total number of mangoes first.
Okay, let me do it. 15 and 17 gives 32. 32 and 22 gives 54. 54 plus 18 gives 72. So we have a total of 72 mangoes.
Very good. Now we will keep the mangoes in these boxes.
Grandpa, how many mangoes can be placed in a box?
The boxes can have a dozen of mangoes.
That means a box will contain 12 mangoes.
Then how many boxes will contain 72 mangoes?
Let me show you. On dividing 72 by 12, we'll get 6, means 6 boxes.
Oh-ho!
What happened, Grandpa?
We have to send mangoes to 10 places and only 6 boxes are made according to 12.
Grandpa, don't we have small boxes?
Yes, we have. It's a great idea, Goody. If 10 boxes were to be made, then how many mangoes will be there in each box?
For this, we will divide 72 by 10.
You can pause the video and try to calculate the answer and then verify your answer with the answer shown in the video.
The result is 7.
Some mangoes are still left.
Yes, Grandpa. 2 mangoes are still left.
Well, this is so good. 7 mangoes will comfortably fit into 10 boxes.
And these 2 remaining mangoes?
And this is for you.
Thank you, Grandpa.
So before eating the mangoes, tell me one thing. We have to place these 10 boxes in the car's dicky. Height of each box is 15 centimeters and height of dicky is 1 meter. So how many boxes can be stacked on the top of each other?
Grandpa, what is meter and centimeter?
These are measuring units. See, this is 1 centimeter.
Oh my God, this is so small.
And this is 1 meter.
And this one is so huge, Grandpa.
Yes, 1 meter means 100 centimeters.
So height of dicky is 1 meter, that is 100 centimeter.
Now tell me, how many boxes can be stacked on top of each other?
For this we have to divide 100 by 15.
You can pause the video and try to calculate the answer and then verify your answer with the answer shown in the video.
We are left with 6 and 10. So 6 boxes can be stacked on the top of each other.
It's good. We have to keep 10 boxes. So 5 boxes can be stacked one upon each other on one side and the rest 5 boxes can be stacked on the other side. And still, we will be left with a lot of space.
5 and 5 and we are done with 10 boxes.
So what did we learn today? How to use measurement for everyday tasks? Measurement is dependent on many factors. We saw how to solve questions based on measuring units of length such as meter and centimeter. Thank you.